Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Ashu's Biology. So in this session we are going to study the sexual reproduction in flowering plant itself, but before that, in previous session we have studied the structure of carpel, megasporogenesis and development of female gametophyte. So I'll suggest before seeing this video, please refer to the previous session. So in that I have explained you properly how the female development took place and how the embryo sac was formed. So in today's session we will see what are the nuclei and the cells present in the embryo sac, the mature embryo sac. Yeah, so if you remember, in the previous video we have seen how from the functional megaspore with the three successive mitotic division, the mature embryo sac was formed. So see, here it is very simple, but this structure of this embryo sac, it is very, very important. So if you remember, as we have seen, the structure of ovule, which contains the two ends, see, microbilar end and chalazal end. But when we say in which ovule the microbilar end is downward, see, basically we have seen in angiosperms, the ovule is anatropous. And what is the meaning of anatropous? Means the microbial, it is downward, that is anatropous. So here you can see, total if we count, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many nuclei? After the development of female gametophyte, 8 nuclei are formed. And if we count the cell, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So how many cells? 7 cells. So this embryo sac is also called as 8 nuclei, 7 celled structure. See, remember it very and listen it very carefully. The embryo sac in female gametophyte, it is also called as 8 nuclei, 7 cell structure, because it contains how many nuclei? 8. And how many cells? 7. Now which are the different cells? Let us see that. See, the cells which are present towards which end? Towards the chalazal end. They are called as 1, 2, 3. How many cells? 1, 2, 3. They are called as antipodals. The antipodals are present where? Towards the chalazal end. Yeah. Next, here downwards you can see there is 3 cells. Out of these 3, the red color 2, these 2 red color you can see, these are nothing but the synergids. These synergids, where these synergids helps? When the pollen tube enters from here, now this pollen tube comes from where? From the male gametophyte. When this enters, the synergids help to burst the pollen tube. How? It provides this water. It provides the water. So this red color you can see, towards which end? Microbilar end. They are synergids. And the most functional thing, which is very important for fertilization, that is your egg cell, or you can call it as ovum. It is also present towards which end? Microbilar end. So at micro, if anyone asks you that where the egg cell is present, towards which end? Towards microbilar end. Where the antipodals are present? Towards chalazal end. And in the central, it is called as central cell. This is a central cell which contains which nuclei? Polar nuclei. And I will tell you, when we will study fertilization, that how the pollen tube enters and how the fertilization takes place in angiosperm. One of the most important concept in angiosperm. So this was all about embryo sac. So see, some of the important points I have given here, very simple. See, after mitosis, yes, we have seen the development of female gametophyte. Okay, the mitosis takes place and it forms how much? 8 nuclei are formed. We have seen just now. How many nuclei here? 8 nuclei. Simple. Yeah, out of that we have seen, these are in the form of nodes I have given to you. 3 nuclei move towards micropylar. So the 3 nuclei which move towards micropylar, out of that, they are, see, out of the cell, 2 are, out of 3, 2 are synergids. We have seen already, and 1 was egg cell, that is we call ovum. See, here only we see this 3, out micropylar end, egg cell, 2 synergids. Simple, yeah. And other 3, the remaining 3, it will move towards chalazal end, and we call them antipodals. Simple, here you can see this 3, towards chalazal end, antipodals, okay. and at the center we have seen two polar nuclei, that is a central cell. So which structure they form? Seven cell and eight nuclear structure, which is already we have seen it is called as embryo sac. So these were some of the important concept in today's session. It was a very small session, but in next session we will see the continuation of this, that how the pollination takes place, how the fertilization occur, and the most important concept is in angiosperm how the double fertilization takes place. So see, I request you all, if you have any doubt, please let me know. So write in a comment box so that I can clear your doubts. And please see all the slides, all the sessions, all the videos. If you will see it in continuation, you will understand each and every point. Thank you.